here. I'm an arch liberal. And he finds me very suspicious because I'm a professor. What I can't face about someone I love, that my son loves me, what would prefer not to see me too much. Every Sunday night when I call him in North Carolina, where he lives with his wife and two children, I can hear the heaviness in his voice, his hello tempered with impatience. Our conversation stiff and stilted. They always think I can talk to a stone. Strangers in buses and trains tell me their life histories. Acquaintances tell me about their affairs and shattered marriages, show me the secret undersides of their lives. My graduate students vie for my attention. They want to sit next to me and carry my bags and fetch my lunch. But my son can't wait to get off the phone with me. I ask him how the kids are, or specific questions about school, ask about his wife, his job. He answers with one or two words. They're fine, or okay, or the same. My son is a lawyer. He was always brilliant with language, at least written language, and he can read a 300-page book in an hour and remember every detail. But with me, he turns mute as a stump. If I ask for help with some legal problem, he will give it. But I do not hear in his voice the lilt I hear in my daughter's voice when I call her. Instead, I hear reluctance, as though his attention were focused on some truly fascinating person and he can't wait to get off the phone. I tell stories that I hope will amuse him, but finally, after struggling and finding no response, I can't wait to hang up. I say, well, John, have a good week. Give everyone a hug for me. I know my son has divorced me, somewhere deep inside himself, in a place he doesn't look at. I am too much for him, too loud, too dramatic, too frantic, too emotional. I laugh too much. I wear him out in a minute and a half. If he never saw me again, he wouldn't miss me. And this is what I can't face about someone I love.